Hey, how y'all doing, girl? It's not looking good. I gotta let you guys know what's going on. They are selling the videos, Diddy Freak Offs, with certain celebrities behind the scenes. They are selling them in Hollywood. How disgusting is that? So, in this video, she's gonna tell us all about the videos that they're selling of Diddy and his freak offs and these top celebrities. And also, Dr. Umar, a black king, he speaks out about Diddy. He said Diddy should have been married. That would have helped his image. Also, another black king speaks out, Taye Diggs. He says that, he really looked up to Diddy. He was shocked to hear about all these situations. And we have a clear queen, Kendra. She is speaking out, and I guess she said that something happened to her during the Diddy situation too. So in this video, we're going to discuss everything that's coming out currently, and they are saying that Diddy was giving out candies and food to lure 16-year-old girls in to the freak-offs. She said she tried to run away, but it was so many security guards that was tracking her down, bringing her back, and she said the only reason why she went there because he was offering candy canes and Snickers and cotton candy. And when she got there was so many older men there that was trying to get her into going to the freak-off room. So she said, that caused her a lot of anxiety and she wanted to panic attack, and she's gonna sue too. All right, so let's look. Make sure you guys like, share, and subscribe here at this YouTube channel, The Messy Sweet Spot. Let's see what's all the fuss is about.
Was recently contacted by someone who wanted me to essentially represent them in the sale of one of the Diddy tapes. So, which I declined that because
Wait a minute. Say that again. Say that again. Back up. You're saying that there's tapes and they're being shopped?
yes, there have been people already
We've
shopping.
heard about the tapes,
Yes.
but the shopping thing is kind of
Yes,
new.
there already have been tapes leaking around Hollywood, being shopped around to individuals in Hollywood. But one particular person contacted me to shop a particular video they were in possession of and to contact the person who was in the video to see if they were interested in purchasing the video before it became a public
I've
knowledge.
heard this before, so like a catch and kill.
Catch and kill, correct.
Wow, can you? And I guess you can't reveal the person who is on the
No, I can't
tape.
explain who the person was, but
High profile?
Mr. Combs was in the tape, and this other person is, I would venture to say, more high profile than Mr. Combs.
Really? Really? And you've seen it?
I've seen stills of the video.
Okay.
I
So you can verify
request it,
that.
I that it exists, that it's real, that the other person in the video is very visible. It's no question if it's that person in the video, and I can tell the video was pornographic in nature.
Oh my. All right. So we know that he videotaped a lot of activities at his home, did he? And it sounds like there was probably a lot of hidden cameras as well. Is that what is being talked about?
Yes, this was actually in his Atlanta home, at a
Okay.
home he had in Atlanta at one point. And it does seem that it's the person isn't like looking into the video, so it's to me doesn't seem like that person knows they're being videotaped. It doesn't seem like they're active participant in the videotaping, like they're being surreptitiously recorded it.
All right. I wonder
we're just going to like one or two, but like again, like I had a great time in my youth. Like I don't really see anything, like I never saw anything really bad happening around me. Sex is sex in my opinion. So I'm not saying that something bad didn't happen. I'm saying that nothing bad ever happened to me.
And that you never saw anything out of the ordinary that you wouldn't usually see at a big Hollywood party, you know? It's sexualized
It's
in
look,
a
you're
way.
going to the Playboy Mansion. What do you know, there's girls topless in the grotto.
But all of it blindsided me. Everything. You know what I mean? So, it's kind of the double-edged for me. So on one side, I'm like, well, this is great for people to know that this happens. We can think that life is to be lived a certain way. We can think a person is a certain way, and they can be the exact opposite and get used to that. You know, I really, he was a hero to me. I loved how he, he didn't come from much, and he started out as a dancer, and you know, all the things that I wasn't growing up, he was. So much confidence, and then it, you know, had a certain arrogance that I loved. And then he made, you know, black, being black, cool.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I came from a place where, you know, we had to ask everything, and, you know, well, I'm black, so of course I'm going to be treated like this. And I looked at him, and he wore it like as a bat, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
So I really put him on a pedestal, and it was disappointing to see some of what happened. I couldn't believe it.
Without Puff around, who knows what people will try to do to get at whatever little is left of his empire after he's convicted, if he's convicted. I don't think he wants to leave his children in this world defenseless like that with the kind of enemies he got, black and white. I don't think he wants to do that. Now, I can see the power structure falsely claiming that he's on suicide watch if, God forbid, they try to take him out of here. I'm concerned for the brother's safety more than I am worried about a potential suicide. And let me tell you the mistake Puff made that Jay-Z did not make. And I am not accusing Jay-Z of anything. I want to be clear. But let's say hypothetically, if Sean Carter had any skeletons in his closet, one of the most effective things he did to clean up them skeletons and seal off those skeletons art, he got married and created a family. One thing you see Caucasian men do, Art, they might be cross-dressers, they might be homosexuals, they might be pedophiles, they might be murderers. What do all white males in the public eye do to make sure they're protecting their image legally and publicly? They get a wife, and they have children. They build family. Look at them. Every last one of them build a wife. They might marry a prostitute, but they are going to have a wife, and they are going to have children because it protects their public image from the types of accusations that Sean Combs has. You cannot underestimate the power of perception when it comes to you being accused of sexual crimes, whether you're innocent or guilty. That is the one thing Sean Combs should have learned. It's a lesson he should have learned, and he learned it too late. Get married, build family. And I'm not saying Sean Carter only married Beyonce for that. I'm not saying. I believe he loved his sister. T.I. and Tiny been together since the beginning, so we know that wasn't a Hollywood marriage. That's real black love right there. I'm simply saying, if you're going to be out here doing the things that Puffy does, get your ass a wife and build a family. He had the children, Art, but he didn't have the wife.
All right, and I agree. That came, Dr. Umar. He knows what he's talking about. You know, he is speaking so much sense. Shout out to Dr. Umar, you know, phenomenal. All right, I'm going to get on out of here. Make sure you guys comment. I want to know what you guys think about all this. And I will see you guys on another video. Bye.